coming into the cage. First one to enter, the challenger. It's 125 pounds.
Guys are so small, they're legitimately half of my weight.
They're about, I'm about four of them.
I don't think you're that big, Kyle. Everyone's got their hype club in the back hyping them up.
MBMA.
And just
bell.
Random spectators.
Just a young gun with a quick fuse. I was uptight, wanna let loose. I was dreaming of bigger things and wanna leave my old life behind. Not a yes, sir.
Having a look of determination on Mr. Newell's face right now.
Have a seat in the foyer. Take a number. I was lightning.
Being accompanied by Dub Holmes, San Antonio. Rob Bass, let's go on and on.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is our main event of the evening. It is scheduled for three rounds, and it is for the Cage Wars Flyweight Championship. This bout is brought to you by Jules Design Studio, County Waste and Recycling, Eric's Auto, Ryan Clark Realty, Marcelino's Pizza, O'Cryo, Schenectady Redemption Center, the Hodorowski Group, MMA Records Radio, Night Moves Gentlemen's Club, Sticker Mule, Rep City, Bricklayers Local Number 2, Local Allied Craft Workers, and My MMA News and Carol's Corner Podcast. This championship fight is also sanctioned by the United States Muay Thai Association, Executive Director Ed Kinner, and USMTA President Clint Haliger in attendance this evening. Your judges for this championship bout are Mr. Eric Komar, Rob Axisa, and Mr. Nels Larson. The fight doctor at cage side for this championship fight is Dr. Michael Sheridan. And now, ladies and gentlemen, live from the event center at the Rivers Casino and Resort and around the world on pay-per-view, three rounds of heart-stopping mixed martial arts action. Let's do this! Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, representing Ty Chi out of Syracuse, New York, Sam Mikhail. And his opponent fighting out of the red corner, representing Mohawk Valley Mixed Martial Arts, out of New Hartford, New York, he is known as Short Fuse Mike Doolin.
There you have it. 4-0 out of MBMMA.
Short Fuse it is.
And the man in control of the action at the sound of the bell is Mr. Mike
Veteran 3-3.
Walzer.
Both these guys are no stranger to the cage. Mike Walter brings them in the center.
And we're about to get going, ladies and gentlemen.
Both these guys look ready.
Here we go. Keys to victory. I think Doolin's got to get his striking off first. I think McCall wants to be the aggressor in this.
They take center of the cage. Oh, Doolin with Doolin's a nice right hand, leading with the right hand, though. Might want to try to set that up a little bit.
That's the second time I've seen an uppercut tonight. Not something you usually see in MMA. Doolin's very patient again, just like he was in his last fight. His earlier fights in his career is very aggressive and attacking.
Very sporadic, aggressive. Yeah. Oh, nice shot. 1-2, right hand, left, right.
Everything right now, his last two fights, including this one, everything's timed and there's thought put into it.
Both these guys are very calm. They're taking the center of the cage. They're willing to engage.
There's that right again.
Both are very calm. Sam's really trying to work those kicks a little bit more than Davey's trying to work those hands. If you notice, when Davey comes forward, he drops that right hand. That could be an opening for Sam.
You saying Davey?
Yeah.
This is Michael.
Mike, I'm sorry. When
There's
it comes
three
in,
of them.
Yes, I'm sorry. Sorry, fellas. When he comes in, he drops that right hand. When he comes in with that jab. Let's see if Sam can identify that and do something with it.
Last time he finished with a big TKO. Ooh, that was close.
David Mitchell says he wants Doolin.
Who said that?
Dave Mitchell. Doolin, nice shots, but McCall doing a good job defending. Both these guys are very comfortable in the pocket.
McCall's 3-3, Doolin's 4-0. Doolin is the Cage Wars flyweight champion.
Doolin's a little bit longer, and he's definitely using that to his advantage right now.
This is the game of patience right now. Ooh, that's just missing by just a little.
Close, only cows and horseshoes and hand grenades,
indeed,
though.
Indeed.
Again, Sam is unwavered here, though. He's still coming forward. He's still willing to engage. There's nothing that Mike Doolin has done that has really making him take a step back yet.
There he is with the takedown attempt.
Oh, but Mike's got the neck. What can he do with it?
Doolin's fighting it off.
Can Sam control that leg? Looking for that single up against Cage.
Oh, big takedown by Sam McCall.
Now what's he going to do here? Can he keep Doolin on the ground into mount? Tries to sink the hooks in.
Doolin's going to work with hand control. Only way he's going to really stand up in this situation.
If you notice, so he's only got one hook in. Let's see if Doolin can shake him off. Return.
Doolin's going to want to put that hip
to
the mat right there. There he is.
Mike Walter ready.
Job by McCall.
And that's the round. Wow, that's a tough round to call, Kyle.
That is a tough one to call. I think when you're in that situation, Doolin is with McCall on your back, you definitely want to throw his hips to the side, get him off through so he doesn't have any balance or traction on top.
But how do you call that round?
I'm going to have to give that one to McCall. They were striking back and forth a little bit. Doolin, I think, had the edge in his striking standing. But that takedown, I think, a little heavier. Plus, capturing the back and throwing strikes while you're on top.
Yeah, so, if you give one-to-one to striking and grappling, then the next criteria is cage control or aggression. So let's see what the judges saw, whether it was Doolin's aggression or whether it was McCall's aggression.
That could be a 9-9 round. Or 10-10 round.
It could be a 10-9 round, but depending upon what judge.
I'm saying the judges could maybe see that as a draw round.
Could be. That was pretty equal.
And here we go, ladies and gentlemen, round two of the main event, flyweight championship here at Cage Wars 40, Night of Champions.
They meet in the center of the cage, good sportsmanship.
There we go.
Ready to go.
See what Doolin kind of adjustments he makes. Avoid that takedown.
Doolin's got a very unorthodox kind of stance, chin up, hands out wide a little bit. Welcoming his opponent.
Well, here's some real adversity for him. Is he going to step up to the challenge and become more aggressive, or is he going to stay patient through this fight? see how he reacts to this. I think he looks like a little worried about that kick.
Oh,
McCall hit him a little bit.
He's almost taking that Conor McGregor kind of long traditional stance.
That's, I've said that too in the past, that Doolin reminds me of a mini McGregor, an amateur mini McGregor. He's getting countered right now by McCall's left after he throws that right, like you were talking about earlier in the fight.
And McCall is chasing him down. He's controlling the cage. He's controlling the aggression. There's been no grappling as of yet. So right now, McCall definitely has the edge in this round.
Doolin looks a little winded right now.
Oh, nice leg kick by McCall. Let's see if they start to add up here. Oh, nice uppercut by Doolin. That
Ooh,
was sneaky.
Nice right.
Oh. Beautiful thing about a fight is it can end at any second.
That is true. And Doolin's starting to put some pressure on.
McCall swinging back, though. Sam kind of taking a second to compose himself. Doolin with his own kick. Looks like he said, you hit me in the groin. He's not complaining, just let him know.
Made sure the boys are still there.
Nice jab.
There's that right. His right hand's down and it got caught again.
That's that we called that earlier.
Yep.
And again, it's that unorthodox stance. It works to sometimes your advantage, but
oftentimes, there's that big right.
Oftentimes it will be a disadvantage if your opponent can highlight that. Oh, McCall, a little bit wavered there.
I think if he followed up with a solid left, he probably would have done some real damage, Doolin.
I agree. He's a little bit, McCall's a little bit more flat-footed right now.
This is an interesting second round.
Oh, he's getting a little weak in those legs, even though he's coming forward. If Doolin can tag him coming in.
I think Doolin needs to start pushing forward a little.
You hear the chants of Doolin from MBMMA and the spectators back here.
He's been just throwing heavy right hands. He needs to start putting a little pepper in there.
Yeah, this isn't 1995 and Dan.
Oh, big. Wow, big body
nice
shot.
Combination.
Oh, another one.
Nice body kicks.
And McCall's pouring
wow,
it on.
Nice hands, nice hands.
Oh, and Doolin answers with a right, but McCall goes right to a takedown.
Wow, good job by McCall. Not only did he engage and take the better position of that engagement, but he also took the dominant position with the
McCall's
takedown.
McCall's getting some strikes in at the very end of this round. His takedown's huge, right into
Absolutely.
Full mount.
End of the round again. What are the judges seeing there at the end of that round? They're seeing him in a very dominant position.
Most definitely.
This is our third and final round.
If you're in Doolin's corner, what are you telling him, Kyle?
I'm going to tell him he needs to start pushing forward, create some angles, and then go in. He just kind of is going straight in and then backs up and keeps walking backwards, trying to counter. I personally think he needs to cut the corner and throws more than one strike. Stop throwing the right so much. A couple of lefts in there and get some jabs in.
I agree. You know, work the knees. I mean, you can tell Coach Dubb won't tell him to breathe and keep your composure. He's telling him, it's looking like he's telling him to get more aggressive with something.
At least go forward, because you got McCall over there who is pushing forward, and he's finding a lot of success doing that.
And then you got McCall's corner now, who's very calm, right? Duff Holmes over here screaming his heart out, trying to get Doolin motivated. McCall's corner's nice and calm, like it's another day at the office.
Yep. This is a big round for Doolin. I really think he's down 2-0 right now. So he needs to find an answer in this third round. We'll see if he can.
David Mitchell says he needs to keep his hands up as well.
You had to get the mouthpiece before we close the door. Here we go, mouthpiece in.
Mike Walter.
Round three. Go, final round of the evening. Cage Wars 40, Night of Champions. Can Doolin retain his championship title at flyweight, or McCall would claim it?
That lead uppercut is good if somebody's coming in for a takedown, but McCall's kind of just hanging out back there. That's going to be tough to land.
See, Doolin's backing up once again, and McCall's moving forward. Find a little success with the right hand,
good
Doolin.
Good job with the feint by McCall. He sees that Doolin's trying to time him. Nice leg kick. He's really stepping into that.
Those kicks are definitely a nice change of pace for McCall.
It is, yes. Nice job, and it's definitely helping him keep himself a little bit longer, being the shorter man.
And Doolin's not throwing kicks. He's just throwing big, heavy right hands.
I think I've seen one.
Couple lefts, and that's about it, to be honest.
And he got tagged again. He really should keep those hands up and parry some punches with that right hand.
I'm surprised he hasn't gone for a takedown. In the last fight, he got a big takedown, which is what kind of found his success in the fight.
Oh, nice
that's
leg kick again
by
McCall.
Nasty kick.
Leg kick's my favorite.
Good.
You're not going to be walking straight for a week after that.
Nice leg kick again.
We're 1 minute down in this fight. 3 minute round.
Ooh. Doolin's still trying to time him. He's looking for that shot that may take Mikal out.
That's a nice body shot. It's a different change of pace from what he's been doing. But those need to be a little earlier in the fight.
You hear Dove Holmes screaming, overhand 2-5, overhand 2-5. It's an overhand right shovel hook. Left shovel. Throw the five, he's saying. Throw the five. That's a lead shovel hook. He's asking Doolin to throw that lead shovel hook. Nice job with that knee by Mikal.
Mikal's really eating a lot of his power. And that power's not going to be as much power when you're throwing it 100 times a fight.
Especially when you kick that leg that many times. You know, you're not able to
produce as much power by
pushing through the floor.
Yeah.
I think we're
a minute left in this.
Oh!
He needs to go forward.
That's what Doolin's looking for right now.
And there's a big cut right now.
Good job by Mikal sucking the legs in. He's about to take the back. He may be a little bit high, though. Let's see if Doolin can feel that.
Oh, you got those hooks in deep.
Yeah, but he's awful high. Let's see what Doolin can do here.
In this position, I think Doolin wants to pull that hand forward and stand up. Good job recovering by Mikal.
Looking for that arm. He sees looking for Doolin's right arm. Watch him step over for an arm bar. There we go. He's looking for the arm bar. He's nice and patient. Do a little ground and pound. Michael's doing the right thing. Turning in. There it is. There's that arm bar. Can he finish him? Nice job by Doolin. Oh, he's belly down. Not a good position for an arm bar.
Man, he is bloody right now. That's the fight, ladies and gentlemen. Will we have a new champion? How do the judges see that fight?
You know, I got to give that fight to Mikal.
I agree 100%. I think he just had a better game plan for that and executed it well. Look at the blood all over him.
Doctor's coming in, check the fighters, check the cut. Mikey caught him with a really nice punch at the end of that round to open him up.
He hurt him. He was stumbling at one point in that round. I think he just waited a little too long to get into action there.
And it looks like Mike Doolin left the cage. Mind your motherfucking
business. No, they're both in there still. Doolin's feeling those leg kicks. You can see the redness all over his left leg. I just don't think it was enough for him to win that.
No, I would definitely say that that's Mikal's fight. But again, who knows? One judge or maybe even two may have seen it another way. That's the thing about, you know, as a fighter, you never want to leave it to the judges.
So will we hear still or are we going to hear new? That's the question.
I say we hear new. What do you think?
I think 100% new. At least two to one rounds.
Sam
Mikal just did too much and was too effective in this fight.
And in the judging criteria of effective striking, effective grappling, then octagon
or cage control,
Mikal
got the advantage. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we go to the scorecard. Nels Larson scores the fight 30-27. Eric Komar scores the fight 29-28. Rob Axisa scores the fight 30-27. For your winner by unanimous decision out of the blue corner,
Sam Mikal.
Sam Mikal.